Hello friends, welcome to Tech with Viresh. So in the continuation to our series of having a deep dive into the Apache Spark world, today we'll take up one very interesting question, and it comes in interviews very often, that how you can join two RDDs or data frames without causing any shuffle. Very interesting, right? Join is one of the primary reasons why shuffles are happen. It's a main point of contention where the performances become laggard, because joins cause a lot of shuffling behind the scene from different partitions across the nodes. So if somebody try to ask you a trick question, in the sense, is it possible to write a join where you do not have a shuffle altogether? Yes, it is possible in Spark, and today we'll see how we can do that. So let's start. Let me repeat the question again. So question that we have for today is, there's a two data frames, and let's say one data frame is small, what we are calling as small data frame, and another data frame is large, and we need to join them on some ID column, which is the common column between two data frames. And the ask is that it should not cause any sort of shuffle in the job execution during that particular join. And yes, one very quick answer could be, let's do a broadcast join. It will not result in any sort of shuffle, because if my small data frame is really small, the default size threshold for broadcast is 10 MB. So if my small data frame is 10 MB and I have not explicitly disabled broadcast that, because by default it was be enabled, so it will result. And if I'll try to do a small data frame and large data frame, it will result in broadcast join. And in broadcast join, as you know, it'll copy that small data frame on the corresponding nodes where the large data frame and the partitions are residing. And then the join will happen when the partitions will co-locate, and thus there would not be any sort of shuffling. Only the broadcast would be performed. But the trick of the question is, broadcast join is disabled. You cannot use broadcast join. Then what can we do to write a join without shuffle? So let's see. So the solution is, you'll again have to go at the conceptual level, that why the shuffle would not happen. Say shuffle will not happen in the cases where the two partitions of the two RDDs I'm trying to join are co-located. They are part of the same partition, and they are on the same node. So when the join will happen, it will match the corresponding records, and then in that case, the Spark doesn't need to do the shuffling of the data across. So the solution lies in the fact that we'll have to co-locate the RDDs and the partition with the joining key. So we'll have to make sure that the records with the joining key, with the common key, are co-located in the same partition. So how we can do that? At a very high level, we'll have to tweak the default partitioner that we have, or we'll have to do the partitioning of the two data frames, RDDs, in such a way that, you know, joining keys with the same value come in the same partition. And this can only happen, as we can see here, the same partitioner is used for the two RTDs, so that will use the same algorithm to partition the data, and that partitioning should happen on in such a way that the keys with the same value come in the same partition. And the second condition that we'll have to match, that this should be done as part of the same action, which is the common action that we have is the join. And that is how we'll have to design our code. So that first is the two RDDs, two data frames which we are going to join, should be partitioned using the same algorithm. So in default, we have two partitioners provided by Spark, the hash partitioner, hash map partitioner, and the range partitioner. Let's see the solution in more detail. So if we do a join without doing any explicit partitioning and stuff like that. So this is your one RDD, RDDA, and this is your RDDB. These are the different partitions. And when you try to join, there would be a lot of shuffling to bring the data for the common keys for your joining key into the corresponding matched partitions post joining. So it will result in a lot of partitioning, a lot of shuffling across. As you can see, these are all wide transformations. And here the partitioning of the two RDDs is handled by Spark in default way, so that they have two different partitioners, two different instances of partitioners, which is kind of doing the partitioning, right? And that certainly is the most expensive behavior of a join. Could be that's an absolute dislocation of the joining keys, and so Spark has to shuffle all the mashed data onto the corresponding partitions. Now the second situation, what we try to do is for the RDDA, we have partitioned it with the known partition. When we say known partitioner, if you have an RDD, you can simply check rdd.partitioner.get, and it will tell you which is the partitioner used under the hood by Spark to partition that RDD. Whether it will give you none, that means there is no known partitioner. That means you've not explicitly used any partitioner to partition it. Otherwise, if you have used some partitioners like a hash partitioner to partition your RDD, it will give you that name of that partitioner. So here what we try to do is we have used a known partitioner. So that known partitioner means we have explicitly went ahead and did the partitioning of the RDDA with the hash partitioning algorithm. So if you say, so if you see on this side, on the RDDA side, my transformations have become narrow for that particular joining key. The only shuffling is happening for this side. This is RDDB, because here we do not have a known partitioner. So it will settle down a lot of things. It will reduce my shuffle, but not entirely. So what we eventually have to do, we'll have to partition RDDA and RDDB using the same known partitioner. We'll create a common instance of hash partitioner is equal to new hash partitioner n, where n is the number of partitions, and that should be used to partitions these two RDDs. We'll see the code snippet how it is done. But if you see, if they will be partitioned using the common algorithm with the same number of partitions, so here you see all your joins will become narrow transformations because the joining keys are located in the same partition. If you see, the joining keys are located in the same partition from both RDDA and RDDB. Right? So this is the highlight of the solution, what we need to do. Let's see how we do it. A quick code snippet, how we can achieve it. First of all, this is a given condition. This is how you can disable the broadcast join, default broadcast join. Even if you disabled it, if you give an explicit hint in the form that you want to do an explicit broadcast join, that will work. But Spark will not call the broadcast join as default. You also made the sort merge join is false, because that is the default join strategy. I've discussed in my previous video where we compared all the three joins, so we have made it false as well. This is just a shuffle partitions. By default it is 200. I just made it 2 for the sake of this particular example. By default the shuffle partitions are 200, and this is how you can change it with this configuration. So what I've done here is I've created a new instance of hash partitioner with the number of partitions as 2. And this is my small RDD. I've created one small RDD, and this is the large RDD data frame. And then what I have done, I did a partition by of the small one with the same hash partitioner HP. Similarly for the large RDD also, I have done the partition by with the same partition. And this is how you can get the partitioner. This is the code to get the partitioner. Small RDD dot partitioner dot get. If there would not be any known partitioner, like we do have a known partitioner, so it will tell me that the partitioner for the small RDD is hash partitioner. Otherwise, it will give me none. So I partitioned these two with the same number of partitions and using the same partitioner. And then I did a join on that, a simple join. And if we'll do like this, so there would not be any shuffle during the join. There would be a shuffle when we're trying to do a partitioning. Right, but that will be a one-time shuffle where it will settle down the partitions based on this algorithm. But when we are doing the join, it would become very fast, because now my transformation has what? It's become a narrow transformation. So I'll get a lot of performance boost here. So that is the interview question. We discussed a very important concept in terms of gives you an highlight into the internal detailing of the things. Just assume if the two joining keys from two different data frames, two records from two different data frames for the same joining key, if they are co-located as part of the same partition, then you can only have the fastest join possible, right? So that is what we have for today. Keep watching. Thanks for subscribing to my channel. If in case you haven't done, do subscribe. Good day. Bye-bye. That's it in this particular video. Keep watching. Have a good day.